Well, as government enforces a crackdown in an Abaco shanty town, the private sector today also initiating its own operation, this one near Pride Estates. Now, it was based on a court order that residents say was given to them by a police officer 2 weeks ago, ordering them to vacate the property. Our intern, Jose Etienne, has that.
Residents were seen packing their household items and removing them out of their homes as they faced eviction and demolition from their shantytown residence in the Carmichael Road area, where they claimed they lived for an extensive period of time. The experience, they say, was an emotional one, some saying that it was unfair.
Depuis 79 mois là so. Bon ma vivre là. Konya yo treatment non façon que yo pa droit pour yo te maltraiter nous.
Now, residents did claim that this property is private owned and that the initial owners, who are now deceased, rented land to these residents. Beatrice Joseph is a resident in the unregularized community and sympathized with those who lost their homes today.
I feeling bad about it because, you know, how they have to go, and I don't know if they have any other places that they could find a home of, that they could be in, you know, or find somewhere for they to, you know, lay their head at night to catch themselves, and then they could find something to live, someplace else to live.
Marilyn Saint-Julien has been living in this community for 40 years, and he says that it hurts to be living there for so many years and be required to leave the property in the blink of an eye.
Comment vous pensez ça affecte mentalement et puis émotionnellement parlant?
Bon, son bagage qui dérange normal dans dit ça me fait toute vie là où on point. Après qu'on est là puis me dague pour me dire quitter là veut dire conseiller de chagrin en façon point. Alors c'est pas octave mais quand même obligé.
As you can see, homes in the shantytown are now being demolished as homeowners are watching this unfold in distress. Now, these homeowners say they are feeling helpless and hopeless because, quite frankly, they say they have nowhere else to go.
This move comes as government continues its shantytown shutdown in communities in Abaco. Works Minister Desmond Bannister addressing the issue in Parliament today.
The Cabinet authorized the Minister of Public Works to review the challenges that are associated with the farm and to coordinate such actions as may be required to ensure that the unlawful practices are stopped.
Attorney Ashley Williams, who represents the estate of John Sherman, where the shantytown was located, telling Eyewitness News the occupants were given ample notice and that the matter was taken to court. He says they had 14 days to respond, which they refused, and action was therefore taken. Jose Etienne, Eyewitness News. Thank you.